Boy Q, man, just got back into Florida from that last load, and I'm shutting down for the night, man. It's blazing out here. I'm sweating bullets, and guess what? My APU just started acting up, and so I have no AC when my truck's off. And my AC in the truck is low on Freon and is acting crazy. So my auxiliary AC and my engine AC is, you know, and I could probably run the truck tonight. I mean, man, I'm sorry, I'm sweating bullets. I could probably run the truck tonight and idle it and get by, you know, because it does cool off enough in the truck where I could be comfortable. But you guys know I am against idling the truck, especially a truck that has DPF on it. It's not good to idle a DEF truck. That's why a lot of guys have problems with their DEF system. And I've not had no issues, knock on wood, with my DEF system in this truck because the truck does not idle. I suspect that the Freon is low in this unit, because it cuts on and it shuts down, and I'm getting the infamous ACS code on the tri-pack inside the truck. And that's usually a sensor, a pressure sensor problem, a fan problem with the condenser, where people are usually blowing fuses. And I'm not having none of that because my unit does start, my condenser fan does kick in, but the unit just only runs for a second and shut off. And I even seen the compressor clutch kick in and kick off and kick in and kick off, and then it shuts the unit down. So I'm suspecting I've got a leak. I have changed this compressor in March and the alternator. I recharged it back then when I did that. And with it being July, if I do have a leak, that's telling me that this is a very small leak. And it lasted for about 4 months. I used the system last night and it ran beautifully all night. AC was working. I did notice though, when I woke up, it was a little bit warmer than it should have been. I think I woke up to about 78 degrees, 77 degrees in the truck, but it was comfortable. It was still a cool, comfortable. So it could have been leaking, and then maybe it just all ended up leaking out today, you know, by the time I got ready to use it. So I'm getting ready to take this cover off, and I'm gonna get back. As suspected, I think I'm low on Freon here. As you guys can see, this compressor is fairly new. I just took this screw and pressed this in, and I'm getting nothing but hot air out of here. And I'm thinking that that's my problem. Oh yeah, I mean, there's no Freon coming out. It's a bunch of hot air. Yep. A little bit of Freon, but not much now. I'm gonna go ahead and let this air out. I bought some Freon. I'm gonna go ahead and recharge the system. And I have to take it in the Thermo King and let them see if they can find a leak. For the time being, it's worth it to me. I just spent about 50 bucks on Freon and a hose to get in here. See, that's there it is. We're just getting a little bit of Freon out now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to charge the system up. Yeah, that looks like oil. Yeah, that's oil. That's not Freon, that's the oil. So it's worth it to me to... Oh. It's worth it to me to go ahead and put the Freon back in it versus idling my truck. You know, I'd rather spend that $50 to save my DPF filters than to spend the money idling the truck and ruining my, you know, putting that unnecessary wear on the DPF filters. So that's the idea behind me going ahead and filling this up. I'm gonna go ahead and fill this up, and then we're gonna try this system and see if it works again. All right. All right, here we go. Let's see if this compressor's gonna kick in for us. Might have to do it a couple times because it might shut off because it ain't no Freon in it. Might have to initially get it going. Temperature I get, and if need be, I'll add the other hand.